Come on now.
Just hope it won't come down hard at harvest this year.
Don't know no rain working a coffee.
Not so fast, Roach. Giddy up.
Hey, you! Yes, you! You got water on the brain!
She cast no spells. On my honor.
An elf's honor worth less than a man's shit.
That's it, Roach.
Sick of it.
Slow now. What was that about?
She spat in my face. Or might as well have. Called me a whoremonger and a witless hack. Can you imagine? Wit is my forte.
Gotta say, Priscilla's really growing on me.
Save it.
And why don't you save your pouting? Prove to her she's wrong.
Exactly what I plan to do. I've always dreamed of having my own cabaret. Bit of paint and plaster, and this place will do splendidly. Just one hitch. I need coin. So, if you happen to get a break between drowners and ecumajigs, maybe you can help an old friend out.
How can I help you?
I dated this girl once, Sophronia. That's a name if you can believe it. Has a merchant for a father, importer of spices from Zeracania. And Daddy Deer would never refuse his daughter Deer a thing. We can borrow the coin from her.
Name rings a bell. Isn't this the woman you abandoned without saying a word? Stepped out for a bottle of wine, never to return?
Knew I bought that wine for a reason.
Long time ago, that.
Been away a while, sure. Which is why I need to draw on your authority. You've got some, you know. No matter what you might think.
Fine. Tell me what you want. Got a feeling you've a plan all cooked up.
Sophronia could still be holding a grudge after our unfortunate parting. But with a touch of help from you, I know she'll forgive me, and then give me that loan.
What's this help entail?
First of all, we need to borrow a dull sword from Madame Irina, one of her props. You know, the kind they use during performances? Get that, then meet me outside Sophronia's house.
Fine, but...
Geralt, the only butts in this plan will be the ones filling my seats. It'll work, you'll see. Get the sword from Madame Irina and meet me outside Sophronia's at sunset.
Old man Newman left me a gift last time.
What?
He never given me nothing but floppy diddly.
If you don't know how to give, you can't receive.
Saying I'm no good at giving?
To give, you've got to turn
Nakwans, and Danians.
What's he schemed up this time?
The last individual who tried to come in on my business, it took them a month to find him. Am I being clear, Chive?
What's the fuss about? Can you not treat me as a bit of healthy competition?
Why are you even talking to him, Duke? I've always maintained two smashed knees are worth a thousand words.
Oh, Geralt! Glad you came.
What's this about?
Ugh, nothing. I just wanted you to meet my new pals before they bugger the fuck off. Because we were just parting, right?
We'll have our reckoning yet, Chive. Soon.
What's this? Some flea-ridden mutant got you scared, Duke? Just say the word. I'll take care of him. Take a peek at what he's got inside, then make the midget eat it. Sound good?
Next time, Earl. Let's go.
Right. Don't show your hides round here ever again.
Well, that puts me up to the neck in fucking shite without a shovel.
Shady, those guys. Who were they?
Puffed up fish bladders, Duke. Word is he's out to be the new horse son, Junior, but the bugger's missing a hell of a lot. Specifically coin, influence, men, and class.
And the other?
Errol. A scum jug like few others. Skin of my arse twitches at the sight of him. Back in Mahakam, we'd send sow buggers like that down the coalface with a bundle of powder and a leaky lamp.
What's this all about? Doing business with them?
Exactly the ploughing opposite. You see, Geralt, old pal...
About to ask me for help, aren't you?
The thing is, I sort of kind of owe a wee sum to a mutual acquaintance, Francis Bedlam, the King of Beggars. To pay off the debt, I've made up my mind to get serious about Gwent.
Getting better by the minute.
Not the playing of it, mind you, but the cards themselves. Rarest of them fetch princely sums these days. Sadly, that's not exactly arcane knowledge. Got a buyer in heat for my collection, missing just three cards. But Duke's dregs are all over my arse, so... What do you say, Geralt?
Fine. We'll try to hunt down those cards. Which ones you need?
Fringilla, Vigo, Isengrim, and John Natalis. Devilish hard to get hold of. Duke's been trying too, hasn't had any luck.
Wait, you don't even know where to look for these cards?
Nah, it's not as bad as that. I'm betting Zed's got them. He quit fencing recently, only deals in cards now. Unfortunately, the arsewhite won't talk to me. Not after I bought a one-of-a-kind Scoia'tael card out from under his nose. Would you mind going to see him?
Zed. Sounds familiar.
Big fish in the card pond. There's a shop along the south wall. And thank you, Geralt. I actually think I stand to pay off this debt now.
No problem. See you later, Zoltan.
I haven't. Witcher! Old man Newman
looking
left
for
last time.
What? Something unusual.
He's given me nothing but floppy diddly.
Perhaps you can talk some sense into him.
don't know who you're looking for, but you won't find him.
Ah, so good to see you.
Got a request. Need to borrow one of your props. One of the swords you use for stage battles.
My. Whatever do you need that for?
I don't know, but Dandelion claims it's essential.
Oh, yes. I suspected Master Dandelion might have a hand in this. I certainly hope you don't aim to compete with me. Well.
Thanks. I'll try not to damage it. So long.
Economically.
Just look at the fake.
Have a man for himself?
Greetings to the honourable gentleman. Razors, scissors, knives, ground to sharpness mere moments ago.
Need a trim. Think you can manage? So long.
Every man for himself?
Go back to Farkle.
Let you wait.
Ah, finally made it. Listen, here's the plan. Sophronia loves adventure-filled romance novels. I can be a hero in her eyes if I can just save her from a bandit. I'll have her eating out of my hand, and there's no way she'll begrudge me that loan.
Want me to be the bandit?
Knew you'd see the sense in it right away.
Are you serious? That's your brilliant plan?
I never called it brilliant, but any kind of plan is better than none. Written your lines already.
You've written what?
So you know what to say during the performance. Here, Andromask, put it on. Sophronia can't recognize you.
But...
No time! Sophronia's coming! Stick to the plan. We'll meet at the Rosemary in the morning.
Stop right there.
What is this? Help! Save me!
flaxen-haired wench. And bow before the Prince of Thieves.
Not so fast. Drop your sword, scoundrel. This is your first and last warning.
Dandelion!
Tis I, though the scum of the city call me the Crimson Avenger.
No, not the Crimson Avenger.
Silence, vermin! You shall regret the day you were born.
Dandelion!
On guard!
Crimson Avenger!
I've been hit! Ow!
To the house, quickly! He shan't get us there! Eternal fire, what do you want from us? Leave us be!
This rogue will soon run off. I'm sure of it. He wouldn't chance getting caught by the guards. Would he?
Eternal fire burns within these walls.
Grant my plea.
Yes?
Bring my husband back to Elf. He's a good man.
Let us pray.
Honest, righteous, eternal fire, you are my only hope. Grant what I ask and I'll spare no offering.
Brother,
deliver
sister.
Us from evil.
From now on, assume your every move.
White one, take a gander over here. Look awfully suspicious to me, tramp.
Zoltan?
Geralt!
About those cards.
You got them?
Not yet.
So why are you here? Miss me that much? This is no time for chit-chat, Geralt. We need to get those cards.
Old man Newman left me a gift last time.
Snake eyes. What? Got a snake's tongue as well.
Floppy, did he? If you don't know how to give, you can't receive.
Saying I'm no good at giving.
To give, you've got to have talent and character.
Such
hey there,
lovely
handsome.
Natural surroundings.
Easy. I haven't the strength, Geralt. Perhaps you can talk some sense into him.
A good day for commerce.
Easy. Black ones, Redanians. Long as they pay and don't hit. Old man Newman left me a gift last time.
What's the hurry?
He never gave me nothing but floppy diddlies.
You don't know how to give, you can't give.
Saying I'm no good at giving.
To give, you've got to have talent and character.
There's been a misunderstanding. You're here too early.
We agreed to meet today, so we've come today. Supplies are all hauled in and the crew's raring to work. We'll start just as soon as our lovely directress gets round to deciding on the decoration.
But Dandelion doesn't even have the coin to pay you.
Turns out he does now, or soon will. At any rate, he's working on it.
See, it's all peachy. So will you finally decide what style you want for this interior?
Why are you asking me?
Well, the lovely lady seems to be having a hard time deciding. And Master Dandelion said he was torn between boudoir style and theater decor. But that he'd let us know just as soon as we arrived. Now we're here, but no decision's been made. And the lady's horribly surprised she's to choose. Though apparently this whole renovation's for her sake.
For me?
Well, it's not for me. Now, would you please decide where I bust a vessel?
I've no idea what Dandelion is like. Geralt, you've known him long. Say something.
Sure, I've known him longer, but he's never so much as changed his socks for me. Never mind commissioning a full-blown renovation. He's doing this for you, clearly. You should decide.
Both our lives have revolved around the stage, and Cabaret's a form of theatre, in a way. Fine, let's do the theatre decor. I certainly hope it'll be to his liking.
A wonderful choice it is. Gentlemen, you're done lollygagging. Get to work.
Well, well. Guess this cabaret's the real thing.
Ever since Dandelion inherited this place, he's talked about it constantly. I just never expected him to take action. And so quickly.
Who knows? Might even settle down now. You'll have to keep an eye on the business. Who would have known?
Despite what people say about him, Dandelion approaches life very rationally.
We talking about the same Dandelion? Man who loses a fortune worth half of Novigrad in one night?
Dandelion can also be responsible. He always pays anyone who works for him on time, and he's never missed a performance.
Sure hope your opening won't be the first. He's still not here.
Well, he said as soon as he got the coin, he'd go see Polly, our choreographer. She's missed the last few rehearsals. I certainly hope he's not gotten into trouble.
Anything's possible with Dandelion. Let me see if I can't find him.
The ones for Danians. As long as they pay and don't hit.
Polly and her half-brained fiancé. They're fighting. She's the only one in this town who knows anything about choreography, and that lummox won't let her work for me. Hold on. What are you doing here? We were going to meet at the Rosemary.
We were, but you didn't show. Priscilla started to worry, so I came to see how you were doing.
Priscilla started worrying about me? That's so nice.
Less for her than for you, I'm sure. So let's get back.
Did you not hear what's going on in there? We've gotta help Polly. Why do beautiful women always end up with such dicks?
No idea. Stand back. I'll break the door down.
Wait! Do we have to destroy her house? She keeps a spare key around here somewhere.
How would you know she keeps a spare key around here?
It's not as if we started working together yesterday. Before Polly joined forces with Hubio...
You'd visit her? Often?
I'd hide out here while Priscilla and Polly rehearsed at the Rosemary and Thyme. They worked on the dance numbers I composed.
So, Polly's not one of your...
I never mix business and pleasure.
The one exception being Priscilla.
Who you were just saying is worried about us. So enough of the chatter, and start looking.
Fine. Let's find the key.
Find anything?
Not here.
This. Get out of my house!
Watch it, and leave the woman alone.
What the... She's my betrothed!
But I'm not your property!
I love her! I'll not let her sway her ass in his brothel!
Whoa! Slow down there a minute. This is clearly one gigantic misunderstanding. One I can clear up in the blink of an eye.
Shove your excuses up your ass! Sod off, or I'll split your skull!
My friend asked you nicely, so please be courteous in return and hear him out, or we'll settle this another way.
All right. Talk.
Hubio, right? Polly's told me so much about you. She said you're erudite and have an open mind.
You said that? Well, there's a truth to it. My mind's the open salt. But its open-saltedness ends when my betrothed starts wagging her ass around brothels. Get out of here, both of yous. Polly's not going anywhere.
Let him finish. There's no brothel involved.
You see, friend, Geralt just hit the nail on the head. For what you have there is the old publicity placard.
Old?
Very. From a time when my establishment was under different management. I, however, would never let any indecency take place in my cabaret. My very reputation precludes it.
So, what's all this about?
Your betrothed is a first-class artiste, and I want to offer her a position worthy of her talents. She's to be my choreographer, and that in turn means she'll receive a share of the proceeds from every performance she choreographs.
You mean to say... coin?
And fame. No flirting required. You have my word.
Suppose... in that case...
I knew you'd agree.
It's settled then. See you at the Rosemary, Polly.
Well, I'm off.
I'll catch up to you. Whew. Never expected that to go so well.
You handled it well, Dandelion. Man was putty in your hands once you called him erudite.
In negotiation, as in combat, the key is to find your opponent's weak spot and exploit it to the hilt.
So, time to head back?
I've still got to stop by Rotlick's. Commissioned some new placards from him a while ago, but Hubio came across the old version. Plowing artists got some serious explaining to
me. I'll go see Rotlick. You head back to the Rosemary, or Priscilla will have my head.
Really? You'd go?
No, said that for the hell of it. Tell me where he lives.
Portside.
See you soon. Hey there.
Fellas out, Master. We're a bit of coin short another round.
Because we're comrades, see? Witcher, ain't you? We're butchers. You slaughter, we slaughter.
Except witchers earn more. Old villagers pitch in. Lords open their purses. Ladies do light with their legs.
Guess I've been to the wrong villages. Dealt with the wrong lords and ladies.
Come, don't make us beg. What's the witcher for, anyways? To help men in need.
Believe me, doing you a big favor by not giving you coin. Now let me through.
Whoa, Master! You best watch your words. We share a trade, but that don't mean you can treat us like dogs.
Shut it. You'll bring misfortune on us. He's a witcher, can't you see?
Out of my way.
We won't do it.
I will.
I'll not take orders from anyone. In fact, not the least afraid to teach a witcher some manners. Master.
Go home. You're done here. Looking for Rotlick.
You ain't alone. Damn halflings in debt to half the city. But I'm here to scrape mine before the carcass is picked clean.
There's not enough for everyone, so bugger off. Feeding time's first come, first served.
Take what you want. I'm just here for some placards.
You diff. Didn't you hear, mate? This is all mine now. Fuck off, freak.
Here, I thought we'd resolve this peacefully. Damn it!
This mutant! How much Rotlick owes you, but everything in this house is mine. Want to get something back? Try the Vagelbud estate. Rotlick's losing his last crowns at the races, I wager. Now get the hell out of here. Mutants, blasphemers, kobolds.
Pizza rank.
All I had.
Considerable sum in the vet, but you shan't back out of the count, eh? You'll have much of a choice before long.
Come now, old sport. We can...
You, Rotlick?
Henri Rotlick, artist, painter, debtor, and martyr to my art. At your service.
Dandelion sent me.
Oh, yes. Tell him his placards are done and safely hidden away. Yet, alas, I cannot fetch them. A group of angry creditors has seized my home.
Think I might have run into one of them.
Then you know my predicament. And now Count de Louverton has offered me the chance to win it all back. I'm to wager on a race.
Generous, Not just anybody could afford to do that.
De Luverden is not just anybody. He's Duke Sam's youngest son. Sam of the well-known family of gem dealers. One debt more or less makes little difference to him.
What's there to worry about? This is your chance to settle up, get a clean slate.
We've had a spell of bad luck lately. Should I agree to de Luverden's offer and lose, I shall be in bondage to him for all time.
Let's do this. I'll enter the race. You'll bet on me, win, pay your debts, then give me the placards.
You're that good a rider.
Far from the worst. Go tell the Count you accept his offer.
There's a laundry in Far Corners, did you know? They'll wash your clothing for
Thank you. I never expected this. May I ask to what I owe this generosity?
Let's just say I like to do a good deed from time to time. Can we get those placards now?
I'll bring them to the Rosemary in time, just as soon as I settle my obligations.
Fine. See you there.
Ooh! Gods and men, dumbstruck with awe.
Rain again.
Behold,
damn mages.
So I'm afraid to see the surgeon. Never know when they'll accuse him of witchcraft.
Take it easy.
No use doing any work in this rain.
Well, see, the crew's been hard at work. Not bad.
I love it. Especially the, accoutrements on the wall.
Priscilla picked them.
Well, I must admit, you have great taste. What about Rotlick? Did you get the placards?
Rotlick said he'd bring them on his own. Should be here soon.
Great! The best way I can think of to promote the chameleon.
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We'll start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Why not?
That's my boy. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He saw right.
And she say anything about me?
Uh-huh. She said you've gained some weight and that you should bathe more often.
Very funny, Geralt. Shove it.
Well, well. Never thought I'd live to see the day. Dandelion living in monogamy.
I've always been monogamous. Well, near enough. I just changed muses often.
Priscilla, another one for your collection?
No, she's its crowning glory.
One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Oh, wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from the cloak and the dagger.
You mean you didn't?
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am? She's late, of course. She knew how important this night was to me.
Of course she did. Probably just making herself gorgeous. Takes time, you know.
So it's true. A woman's vanity knows no bounds.
Master Dandelion! Priscilla, she's...
What? Speak, man.
She's badly, been attacked. They took her to Volmerius Hospital.
Attacked? She's hurt? Geralt, come with me, please.
Of course. Let's go.
Priscilla, is she gonna live?
Well, I'd say that's certain. Her condition's critical but stable. Beg your pardon, but you are a relative?
Relative? No, a friend. A very close friend.
Dandelion, correct? She uttered the name in her few moments of lucidity. I am Joachim von Gratz, head of surgery. Until recently, a lecturer at Oxenfurt Academy.
Enough of the courtesies. What are her injuries, besides her eye?
A concussion, cranial swelling, incision into her larynx, and scalding inside the throat and esophagus. Clearly someone forced her to imbibe a caustic fluid.
So this was no ordinary attack, no robbery.
Clearly not. It was the act of a demented mind, and not its first.
How can you know that?
I've seen wounds like this. They're not the kind one would forget, don't you agree? In fact, just this week a corpse turned up in the morgue with similar injuries. And no heart.
No heart? You mean that might have happened to Priscilla? Is someone looking into this?
This is Novigrad. Only the innocent burn here.
Geralt, I know I owe you 100 times over, but I need to ask you another favor. Find the bastard who did this. Find him. And kill him.
Don't need any convincing. Come on, Dandelion. Let's think about what we can do. I
would suggest examining the previous victim's corpse. It has yet to be autopsied. Doing so could very well provide some clues. No need to look astonished, gentlemen. As a surgeon, I know the importance of preventive medicine. Rather than wait for this maniac to strike again, I'd prefer to excise him. Not unlike a tumor.
Think they'll let me into the morgue?
By the main entrance, certainly not. But you can also get inside through the sewers.
The sewers? Travel them often, Doctor?
As often as required for, the pursuit of preventive medicine.
Alternative treatments. Aggressive ones, I'm guessing. Interesting.
We can discuss this en route. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Ready and intrigued. I'll get whoever did this, Dandelion. Even if it's Hierarch Hemelfart himself.
Thanks.